Friends, here our concept is redirection operators and standard input, standard output, and standard error. Let me explain that. See, our Linux commands need some input. That input may be a file or any another attribute based on which command you are executing on your terminal. And once it is executed, it will produce some output as well. By default, input is being given with the keyboard, and keyboard is called standard input device. And whatever the command you are executing on your terminal, that may produce success output or maybe an error also. So whether it is a success output or an error, both will display on your screen itself, I mean on your terminal itself. Let me explain with a simple example. Suppose I am trying to list a file. See the result. You are able to see the information about that file, like permissions, user, group, when it was created, right? Now, the same file I am trying to read, but see the result, you are not able to see the content of that file. Instead of that, it is displaying permission denied. Actually, it was failed. It is giving an error. If you observe here, there are no permissions to read others here. That's the reason you are getting an error. That's fine. So whether you are getting a success output or an error, both are displaying on your screen itself. But sometimes you may want to redirect, you may want to store the output into a file instead of displaying on your command line. Or sometimes you may want to run one more command on the present output. Or sometimes you may want to provide the input as a file for your command. So these are nothing but redirection operations. So based on whether input redirection or output redirection, we have different types of operators. They are output redirection operators, input redirection operators, and combining redirections operators. Let me go with one by one. The very first one is output redirection operators. In that we have greater than symbol as the first operator. That is just to create a new file. Nothing is there. It's very simple. Suppose as of now we are running a command and it is displaying your output on your command line. But I don't want to display my output on the command line. Instead of that, I want to create a file or I want to store this output into a file. Then just use greater than symbol. Suppose I am creating demo.txt. Now see the result. Your content is not displaying. Your command output is not displaying on your screen. Instead of that, it is storing in a file called demo.txt. That's it. Now let me run one more command and I want to redirect that output also into demo.txt. And see the result, what is there in your file. Your previous content gone. Now the latest output is there in this file. The reason is, if you use this greater than symbol, if this file is already there, then the content will be truncated and the new output will be stored into that file. In case if it is not there, no problem, a fresh file will be created and into that your result, your output will store. But if you want to keep your old content as it is and if you want to add, append new content to your file, then you have to use for greater than. It's very simple. Now let me, as of now, your content is this one, right? Now I am running with for greater than. So what will happen? This content will be there as it is. At the end, the new content will be appended to your file. Now see the result. At the end, you have a new content. That's it. Likewise, you can run any number of times. See, suppose I am rerunning this command with for greater than. So that your old content will be there as it is and new content will be appended. See that? Just now we appended this content. That's it. Now, next one is input redirection operators. See, simply less than just to provide the input for your command. Anyway, by default, whatever the information you are providing on your terminal, that is the input only. But you can also mention with the less than symbol. Suppose I am doing cat less than demo.txt. That's it. So as of now, don't worry about this less than symbol. We'll discuss in detail in our further sections. That's fine. Now, combining redirection operators. It's nothing but if you want to send the current standard output of one command to another command as a standard input, then you have to use this pipeline symbol. Just observe that. Suppose I am running ls-lrt. So for this command, this is the output. But in this output, suppose I want to get only usernames. Yeah, only permissions I want to get. First field I want to get. That means this command output is this one. This output I want to send as an input for second command. See, with pipeline, with awk command, suppose I am running print $1, so that you are going to get only first field. So how it is running? Simply, it is providing, it is producing some output, and with the help of pipeline symbol, this command will treat this command output as an input for your awk command. That's it. Likewise, you can combine any number of commands. Suppose here I am combining suppose with grep d, then see the result. In this output, in which line we have d, that line is displaying. That means first it is producing this command, producing the output that is giving as an input for awk command, and this final result is providing as an input for this grep command. That's it. That's fine. Now I have a small requirement. Store the Java version into a file using redirection operators. First, let me give the command to find Java version. See the result? Yes. Now I am redirecting that output into a file called javaversion.txt. But your output is not redirecting into that file. It is still displaying on your command line itself. The reason is, for some commands, the output will be produced in error place. Then how to handle it? If it is success output, then we are redirecting into some file with the help of greater than symbol. So our problem is how to separate standard output and standard error. Simply with the help of file descriptors. File descriptors are integer numbers just to identify your standard input, standard output and standard error. So 0 is for standard input, 1 is for standard output and 2 is for standard error. So here I am not touching 0, that is standard input. We'll discuss about in our further sessions. Now as of now, I'm working with 1 and 2, I mean output and error. First let me explain with a simple command. Suppose if I write ls greater than demo.txt, your output is storing into a file called demo.txt. Not only that, even I can mention 1 greater than, it is storing your result into demo.txt. So by default, whether you are going to give greater than or 1 greater than, the meaning for that is store success result into that file. Now, instead of 1, suppose if I give 2, the meaning for this is store only the error output into demo.txt. Suppose if I get any success, don't store, simply display on your default place, that is your terminal. Now see the result. Ls 2 greater than demo.txt. 2 greater than means if your command gives any error, then only store that error into demo.txt. Right? Now what I want to do is ls 1 greater than demo.txt, or let me take success.txt, and 2 greater than error.txt. Now my intention is if ls command gives success, then store into success.txt. If it gives any error, store into error.txt file. Now see the result. First see the success.txt. Yes, content is there in this file. But error.txt, there is no content. Because we know that ls definitely will give success in the current location. That's why that success output stored in success.txt. Now I am giving some invalid command. Then definitely it will produce an error. But on command line, for error and success, place is same. I mean your terminal itself. Now what I am doing is, if this command gives success, then store into success.txt file, and if it gives an error, store into error.txt file. Now see success.txt. We know that some random command, ASFD, that is not a valid command, definitely it will produce an error. That's why there would be no content in success.txt, but that error is stored in now in error.txt. That's it. The same way, even though if command is valid one, some commands will produce their output in the error place. In that case, if you want to store your result into your required file, then you need to use file descriptors. Suppose I am using 1 greater than java version.txt. We know that this will never store your result into java version.txt. The reason is java-version command giving output in the error place. But I want to store error, then use 2. Now see the result. Sorry. 2, not 21, simply 2. Now see the result. That's it. Right? Suppose if you have any confusion for some commands, whether it is going to give success output or error, then simply what you have to do is java -version. Suppose I want to redirect one into this file, java version.txt. Two also you can redirect into same file, so that your success and error both will store into this file. That's it. Now see the content. Fine. Now, instead of giving in this way, one into this file, success output into this file and error also into this file. That means whenever if you have a same file, if you want to store whether success output or error into a same file, in that case, you don't need to write this syntax. You can also do a shortcut, that is java-version 1 greater than into suppose this file, 2 greater than ampersand 1. So that the meaning here is, please store my error also where 1 is storing. Where 1 is storing, success output in this file. So error also storing into that file. That's it. Or you can also write one more shortcut. Simply java-version error and success output store into this file. That's it. Now see that. If you are getting confusion with this syntax, let me create a new file. I am creating new java.txt. Now see the result. Content is there. So friends, if you want to redirect your success output into a file, you can use only greater than, like ls greater than some new text.txt, or you can also give 1 greater than, because by default greater than symbol will consider success output. And if you want to capture error output, you have to take 2. And if you want to store success output into one file, then take 1 greater than into some your required file, then error into some error file. That's it. But if you want to redirect both the outputs, success output and error output into a single file, then you can use directly first file, success output 1 greater than new text.txt. Then second means, 2 means error. Error also redirect into success output place. Or instead of this, you can also directly write shortcut ampersand greater than my file. Suppose I'm giving different files just to see the result. That's it. Now see the result. That's it. Okay. So guys, be clear with 1 greater than, 2 greater than, and 1 greater than. Let me write that lines. They are very important. Defaults to success output. Success output. You have to provide some file name here. Let's say some file name. Some file name. That file name is your wish. Error output. And 1 greater than, suppose I am writing some file name, then 2 greater than ampersand 1. So here, both will store into a single file. It may be success output or error output will store into a single file. Now for this shortcut, you can also write. Here one more thing. Instead of this, I can also write first in this way. File name, same file name. Or for this shortcut is file name, your success output into this and error output where your success output is storing, or directly you can write shortcut in this way. So last three syntaxes are to store your success output and error output into a single file. That's it. Okay guys, thank you.